There's a new vulnerability out called TunnelVision, which lets an attacker inject routing rules directly in your computer so that internet browsing you thought was going through the VPN would actually bypass it and completely remove that protection. Now, I actually tried out this technique in my own lab. Let me show you what it looks like. Here's a victim device connected to a local network. It's using OpenVPN for Linux with a NordVPN New York City server as a destination. Now, it's getting its IP address automatically via DHCP from the default router. Here's an attacker device set up on the same network. It wants to decloak the victim's VPN, so it downloads the Leviathan TunnelVision GitHub project and then runs some various configuration and startup scripts. It then adds code for specific websites it wants to decloak, then launches a rogue DHCP attack to trick the victim's computer to use the attacker's IP as its default gateway. The attacker then uses the tunnel vision technique to decloak some of the victim's VPN traffic. This introduces a bypass on the victim's computer for specific IP addresses. Now, normally, NordVPN's homepage shows a nice green status, but after running tunnel vision attack, the NordVPN website IP address is now decloaked and we aren't protected. When the attacker is done with the attack, they can quietly remove things, remove the bypass, and restore everything back to normal. So how was I able to make the victim's computer bypass its own VPN connection? What's going on here? Because VPN use is so widespread among consumers and remote workers, this tunnel vision technique has generated a lot of sensational headlines. But how bad is this vulnerability really? Is this something you need to be worried about? Or does this impact your VPN and potentially even more than that? Well, to answer these questions, we need to break down how the tunnel vision attack works, which is going to give you great insights in how you can best protect yourself. When your computer connects to a network, it will ask for an IP address from the router, which often runs something called a DHCP server. The server also sends out other networking information like which device is the default gateway, what DNS servers to use, and the range of other computers your computer can broadcast to. So your computer will happily update its network settings based on what the DHCP server tells it. But if someone else on the network runs a fake DHCP server, that could respond to your computer's request first, and they can populate your computer with whatever networking information they want. This can happen on any network that isn't set up to detect and prevent people from doing this. TunnelVision uses a special type of DHCP message called option 121, classless static routes. The static route basically means any traffic designed for a particular IP address should go through this other IP address. It's like having your mail packages take a detour through a different stop before reaching your house. So any fake DHCP server can inject these detours to your computer that could say, don't send traffic going to the internet through the VPN's IP address, instead send it through my IP address instead. And your computer will happily do this because that's what the DHCP protocol tells it, and your computer's networking system is designed to follow these rules. This affects almost every device because, number one, most devices have network settings configured automatically rather than manually. Number two, many networks don't detect or prevent fake DHCP servers, so anybody can start one. And number three, it's easy for an attacker to run this kind of attack and control your network traffic in all sorts of ways, including bypassing the VPN. And it's really important to note that this affects more than just VPNs. Being able to inject arbitrary routes for computers is like NSA level manipulation of someone's network traffic, just on a localized level. And this bypass capability allows you to launch all kinds of attacks. The first of these is the denial of service attack. You could tell devices to route all traffic to some non-existent IP address, causing them to lose all connectivity. You could set this up to only happen at certain times of the day in order to be sneaky and intermittent, cause all kinds of headaches. Another type of attack is a man-in-the-middle attack. For instance, you could redirect DNS traffic for devices to your own malicious DNS, causing those devices to visit the wrong website so that instead of someone getting a news article, they get malware. Or you could intercept and bulk collect a victim's traffic and save it for offline use, and that way you can come back to it and harvest weak credentials or even decrypt that traffic once you gain keys and passwords through other means. So this boring old DHCP server we take for granted can now be used to disrupt any device using it to get an IP address. Just think about all the critical infrastructure out there that's using DHCP, things like power plants, airports, water treatment sites. Manipulating that traffic could cause serious, major physical damage and disrupt all kinds of systems that affect our everyday lives. So what can you do to protect yourself? For VPN users, your VPN client may come with a kill switch feature. This monitors your computer's routing table or VPN interface for changes. And if it detects any traffic not going through the VPN, the kill switch will block all internet access. But using a kill switch opens up the opportunity for an attacker to use it against you. So if they just want to interrupt your traffic, they can send traffic outside the VPN and your whole VPN is going to be killed. So you end up sort of DDoSing yourself, which is not ideal. The second mitigation is to use a VPN within a virtual machine, a VM, configured with NAT networking. The virtual machine will be using the host's own networking configuration and DHCP server and not receive fake DHCP server messages from attackers who are only able to see the host. So this is a good solution if you don't mind working inside a VM. There's also an option of using your mobile hotspot, which creates your own private network 100% under your control. This is a great solution when you're away from your home or office, but it does cost extra money. Another precaution, you can set up firewall rules to only allow DHCP messages from known trusted DHCP servers and drop messages from anywhere else. This is a great solution for your home or office or any fixed network. For enterprise environments, there's endpoint detection and response, or EDR, agents that can monitor your computer's routing table and alert or block on suspicious changes. And finally, there's network security monitoring tools that can detect or prevent fake DHCP servers from running. For instance, the network traffic of my attack demo from earlier in this video, I can see there are two DHCP servers on the same broadcast domain. These are both sending messages to the victim laptop asking for an IP address. This visualization also provides an event alert, allowing me to see the presence of a rogue DHCP server. So what's the bottom line? Are VPNs worthless if we don't follow one of these mitigations? Is there some permanent solution to the tunnel vision vulnerability that can restore all of our confidence in VPNs? Well, actually, in my opinion, the real issue isn't this specific vulnerability. The real issue is our obsession with VPNs as some easy button for all of our cybersecurity woes. In many ways, the tunnel vision vulnerability isn't the problem. There's something foundational that needs improving here. It's more than just VPNs. The real solution is understanding what your devices are doing and how they're doing it. Learn as much as possible about networking fundamentals. Learn about core networking services and protocols. Learn how protocols actually work and how they implement an RFC. It was actually the first time I actually physically edited a routing table and really took the time to understand what a routing table was and how it kind of changed. So I learned a ton, and I now feel better equipped to do my job and defend my networks. Now, I am interested in your thoughts on tunnel vision, both the vulnerability and what to do about it. Has anyone else out there tried out this attack? And if so, what are your own takeaways? Feel free to sound off in the comment section and add to the conversation. Thanks a lot for watching. Check out the links in the file description for links to tunnel vision, the blogs, and other tools. And if you like this video, please like or share on social media and subscribe to our channel. Until next time, stay safe and take care.